Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining me. I am Dr. V, or Dr. Vernita Glenn White, but I go by Dr. V, and I am so happy that you are here. I am CEO and founder of The Vibe Institute, where we help women leaders vibrate higher in their influence, brilliance, and excellence. That is also the home of the CEO Leader, which is a course I lead, and Lead for Ultimate Impact and Influence, which is another course that I lead for leaders. So thank you so much for joining me here today. I was going to talk to you about a few things. I have a series of things that I want to talk about to put out over the next few months as we finish this year strong. And then I was doing my daily devotion and I came across this scripture. Now, don't worry. I am not here to preach. I am not a preacher. I am also not here to impose my beliefs on you. Although a lot of leadership skills and principles actually come from the Bible. I'm just saying, you know, you don't have to believe in the Bible or be a Christian, you know, to be a great leader. Great leaders follow a lot of those principles. But again, this has nothing to do with anything about religion. It just caught my attention because I've read this scripture before, but I see it in a new light today. So I'm going to read it. Again, this is not Bible study, but I want to read it for you. And then I want to talk about how that relates to leadership and then finishing this year strong. So it comes from 1 Corinthians Chapter 9, verse 24, and I am reading the Passion Translation. I love that translation. I used that a lot when I was writing the book about my mom, and it just stuck with me from that. So it says, "Isn't it obvious that all runners on the racetrack keep on running to win, but only receives the victor's prize? But only one receives the victor's prize. Yet each one of you must run the race to be victorious." And when I was reading that, it hit me that we focus a lot on the winners of the race. You know, you get first, second, and third, but everyone runs to get first. I think it was Nelly was like, only winners are number one and no one remembers number two. And then number three, just forget about it, right? But I want to look at that a little differently. While we do want to run the race, we do want to be victorious, we do want to get the prize, the last part of that says, yet each one of you must run the race to be victorious. The fact that you have been in a race. Now, I talk more about leaders. My background is really education. But this applies to all leaders. And if you're not like a leader in the title or position sense of leader, this can still be for you too. So we're wrapping up this year and people are like, oh my gosh, I need to finish this goal. I need to crush this goal. I want to be number one to do this. I want to make sure I have that. But then some of you may be a little discouraged. I want to encourage you to look at the fact that you've been in a race for the goal or your goal for the last few, for the this entire year, or especially for the last few months. Like, let's say you got really, really focused. It's like, okay, July came. I got 6 months left. Let me get it together. Or even if it was like, oh, it's the last 100 days. Let me focus. And then I know some people are like, oh, it's the last 70 days. What was my 70-day challenge? The fact that you've been in that type of race, like you've been, no matter when you started, you were in there, and you may not win the first place prize. You may not hit that goal exactly how you wanted to hit it. You may not have finished the entire book by the time you wanted to finish. You may not have launched the entire course you wanted to launch. Your school may not have hit the gains that you've expected them to hit throughout the semester. Or, you know, insert whatever fits you. But the fact that you got off the sideline to put yourself in the position to get in the race, you should congratulate yourself for. There are a lot of people who may be talking to you, or they may be cheering you on, or they may be telling you to just chill out and wait for 2021. Just start fresh. Don't listen to them, because you, even if you finish dead last, you took it upon yourself to get up, get an idea, get yourself on maybe it was a daily routine or habits that you had to do. You had to cut off some things or some people so you can get this focus and get this momentum. Congratulate yourself and don't listen to them. I don't know if you've ever ran a race. I used to run races, yeah. 5Ks, 3Ks, 10Ks. I think the longest one I did was a 15K. And I wasn't dead last, but I was so far away from being number one. However, when I was running, I'm looking on the sides and there are like more people on the sides watching us than the people who were in the race. And I remember I used to be like, oh my gosh, I'm not gonna be first. My timing is gonna suck. I'm not gonna be at this, you know, at a top tier, whatever. And then looking back on that, like just reading this today, and I was like, wait a minute. The fact that I was in the race at all, I should be proud of that. And I remember people used to say, why do you want to run a race if you're not going to win or this, that, and the other? And I was like, because it's for me to see if I can do it. But they were the people, they're like people on the sidelines. So if you are doing something, and remember, you are the leader, and you're like probably thinking, how does this tie into leadership? You are the leader of yourself first. You have to lead yourself first before you lead anyone else. Acknowledge that you are in the race. A lot of people are not in the race with you. You can look to your left and to your right. You have to determine, are they on the pavement with you or whatever the race is? Are they within the ropes or are they on the outside? Because when you're running the ropes, like some people can follow along or, you know, at the next stop, they can move along with you, not at the same pace, but they can be there with you, but they're not necessarily in the race. So you have to look at that when, if you're hearing advice from people or if people are telling you something, you have to say, are you in the race or are you in the sideline? Because the fact that you may not win or hit everything, and that's the reality, you may not hit it. But if you are 5 steps ahead of where you were before you decided to get into the race, the fact that you went to the table, you registered, you put on your bib, you put on your shoes, you did a little warm up and you got in there, you ought to be excited for that. So I know we all want to finish strong and get that goal. And I'm not telling you to sit down on yourself. I'm not saying this so that you can ease up off the gas. No, you push even further, but I want to give you some grace and ease, you know, for you to have some grace and ease and some flexibility with yourself. I'm writing a book right now and I can't wait to release the title. And I was getting down on myself. I was like, oh my gosh, I just finished this book. I wanted to have my full manuscript by my birthday. I had a big chunk of it done by my birthday. So that took about 30 days. And then I wanted it to be done like this month. And it's not, the book is like done, it's out like in review, but I was beating myself up because I was like, oh my gosh, this should not take this long. And then I was like, you know, it's been less than 90 days that you started from the time you started writing to the time you sent it off for review. You are in the race, even if you didn't make these arbitrary deadlines. Like if the publisher didn't give you this deadline, then what are you freaking out for? Now, is it going to be done this year? Absolutely. Excuse me. But I wanted it to be done like in 45 days or something like that. And it was like, really, give yourself some grace and ease, because there are a lot of people who wanted to write books this year, haven't even picked up a pencil pad, haven't logged on the computer to even type the framework. They're just still, oh, I want to one day. They're still on the sidelines. They're not even on the sidelines. They didn't even come outside. They're still looking on the web page, scrolling through the past pictures of the race, you know? So give yourself credit for where you are. You will be victorious because you are in the race anyway. You have to finish the goal line. I don't think, well, there were some, but I don't think most people who are in the race or doing things towards their goals, I don't think they just flat out give up. I think that they may slow down, but I think they have enough in them to where they cross the finish line, even if they are dead last. And I'll say maybe they've gotten some assistance to cross that finish line where someone had to drag them across. this is the last thing I'll say before we wrap up. If you've never been in a race, I think it has to be over, I think it has to be over a 5K or a five, it starts at a 5K and then it goes up. If you are, they have this tracker and it's a person that drives alongside like the last person at this pace. They keep the same pace. And if you fall behind the tracker, you have to get on the bus or the van so they can drive you off to the finish line. Like, I don't think you get credit or anything, but at least you get something for being out there. Like, I don't even know what they call it, but a thank you for showing up, right? I used to think, oh, that sucks. You didn't get a chance to finish. But they kind of did. They at least got in the race. They may not have been victorious, but they went in with a victorious mindset, and then they were able to make some progress. That's what I want to say. They were able to make some progress. So I do want you to win. I do want you to get the gold and the gold or the platinum, but I do want you to give yourself credit and celebrate yourself for at least being in the race, because you have to be victorious for the simple fact that you got up, put your mind to it, and started moving in that direction. All right, so that is what I have for you. Let me know your thoughts, your comments down below. If you are a runner, let me know like the next race, because I need to get it together. You know, I haven't done a race in like maybe 2 years, which is not cool. So comment down below, let me know what sparked something in you. Let me know if you needed to hear some words of encouragement. And then let me know what something else that resonated with you, okay? So I am Dr. V. Thank you so much for listening and learning with me. And if you want to connect more with me, you can go to drvernitafreegift.com, which I will have down below. And then you can also book a call with me to see, you know, how to help you finish strong and then start the next year even stronger. I can't wait to hear from you, and I will catch you next time. Bye.